Evening and welcome to another live lounge at Martinique Manor. I am, of course, Lady Martinique, and this week it's all about big business. It's 80s, it's shoulder pads, it's over the top, and honey, have we got a lineup for you. We are so happy to be here with you this evening. Thank you, thank you, thank you, one and all, for being here, and welcome to our first production with me having a new staff member. Can't really tell you all the details, but he's here and he's controlling what is going on. So I have no more control over what's happening. And without further ado, let's bring back my partner in crime. She is the one, the only, Miss Pepper Spray.
Hello, darling.
Sweaty. Yes, I love this office. It's very, very, very 9 to 5, isn't it?
Oh, it's fabulous, isn't it? I'm loving the pastels.
Yes. Oh. But now when we came up with this theme for this week, we were thinking 80s, we were thinking big business, of course, Bette Midler, Lily Tomlinson, is that correct? Tomlinson. There we go. And it was just really, really lovely to come up with this theme, and of course we've taken it further and further and further down the road, and we have got some gorgeous guests here this evening that are going to be joining us. And of course we now have Lucian in the control tower. He's just so efficient.
I need to speak to you about this.
About what? There's nothing to speak about.
Lucian?
Yes, Lucian. He just popped in
I
the other day.
A phone call earlier on.
Yes.
From the supermarket.
What supermarket?
Where their delivery boy was.
I know nothing about this.
Are you sure you know nothing about it?
No. Supermarket. Harrods delivers to me, darling.
Well, why is there an ASCO van in the middle of the boating lake? And they said their delivery boy, Luke, has not been seen since his last delivery here.
Totally different person. My man's called Lucian. He's this young, nubile 20-year-old, and he's ready to serve.
And when he came to the door, was he holding one of those little boxes and asked you to sign?
Oh, yes, a computer thingy. He had one of those in his hand. Said his name was Lucian. Definitely was Lucian. No mistake. And then he got me to sign to take ownership of him because he came to the door as a delivery. He's up in your tower, up on your floor.
What, in the West Tower?
Well, you've gone home because of all this COVID nonsense, and someone comes to the door and says, I'm here to deliver me. I'm sure he said, deliver me. And then I just kind of claimed him.
So we've now got an ASCO delivery boy locked up in the tower.
No, honey, no relation.
Doing all your technical shit.
No relation at all. He's totally independent. His name's Lucian. And I signed on the dotted line on that little computer thingy in his hand. And then he happily came in and I just locked him in the tower.
Oh, you're a naughty girl.
I don't know what you mean.
I think I'm going to have to follow this up. So I shall have to go and check on him later to make sure he's got enough water and enough food.
Oh, no, I didn't give him that. He did bring his own, though. He brought a little basket and it had everything sort of pre-packed. It was quite shush. Everything pre-packed. Oh. No, a palm lovey is something outdoors in the outside sunshine. That you kind of, you know, sit under a palm. I don't know what this is.
Anyway, I think we should get on with the show.
Well, we have got... We have got our...
Little trumpet.
...guests to bring in. So first and foremost, let's bring in my guest for the evening, our entertainment guest for the evening, who I shall be entertaining and working with this evening, none other than Miss Carmelle Toe.
Good evening.
Hello.
Sweeties.
Darling, how are we? Darling.
I am feeling fabulous this evening. How are you girls?
I'm having a power surge, but at my age, one does have power surges.
It's the new delivery. I mean, the new tech guy that's done it for
tech her, guy. I mean, Carmelle, if a man arrives at your doorstep and says, sign for me, then you sign and you claim him and lock him away before that's he runs away.
That's how the Fritzels started, darling. Don't go down that road.
That's how the what started?
Fritzels.
Well, I don't know what that is.
That's your homework.
Too soon.
The shade of it all. So, Carmelle, you're my guest this evening, and you're our guest this evening, and you're going to be taking us back to the 80s, three selections of songs that you've done, and we're also talking about big business this evening. And as you know, being a proud supporter and a proud sister, we have done things like, I've done some boas for you, so that's my business that I'm doing, side hustle, and you're doing wigs, Carmelle's creations, aren't you?
Yep, I create lovely helmets.
And Pepper has started making bespoke sets of earrings, but sort of on the, what, Pepper? On the sort of camp frivolous side. We're not going for gold and pearls. Hey, May. We're not going for gold and pearls. We're going for to theme, really. Themed earrings, yes. I suppose they would be.
Yes. Nice and fun, cheap ones.
I heard that frivolous. Pepper also makes candles a bit like a certain celebrity. She makes the scented candles.
Oh. So who's your guest this evening, Pepper? Who's joining us in the makeup scene?
I have bought the most marvellous, beautiful and stunning makeup artiste businesswoman of the year.
Oh.
Beautiful Miss ChrisTeen.
There she is.
On mute.
My God. What an absolute introduction that was. Thank you, Pepper.
No worries, darling. Oh, it's lovely to have you here with us.
So fabulous to be here, my love. Thank you for having me. Thank you for seeing everybody.
No worries. And you're going to go over your lovely products with us, aren't you?
Yes, as I paint and construct this face for the evening, I will be putting stuff on and showing you some bits and bobs as we go.
Amazing. Oh, so any drag queen can kind of just go between all four of us and get everything they want.
Absolutely. It's big business this evening, girls. Pull out your checkbooks. So we are going to follow our new format. I'm just having a look at the new format, because, of course, the show is no longer in my hands. It's in the hands of Lucian, who's locked away upstairs. I mean, why not have a houseboy that can do computers? Oh, there's Janice. Evening, ladies, everyone watching. Hope you're all well. Thank you, my darling. So it now says that we are going to go to our guest for his first song. So her first song. Sorry, Carmelle. Her first song. So Carmelle, we are going to give you the screen, honey. Are you ready to knock our socks off with your first performance while ChrisTeen slaps on a face and Pepper and I go and look for employment?
Come back off a furlough. Yep, I'm ready, babes.
Amazing. Let's give Carmelle the screen.
Testing. There we go. Hello, I'm from the 80s for you, my dears. There's a loving in your eyes all the way. And if I listened to your lies, would you say that I'm a man without conviction? I'm a man who doesn't know how to sell a contradiction. You come and go. You come and go. Come a comedian. You come and go. You come and go. Love and peace if your colors are like my jeans. Red, gold, and green. Red, gold, and green. If you're with it once every day. And you used to be so sweet, I heard you
say that my love was an addiction. When we click, our love is strong. When you're gone forever. You string along, Come a chameleon. You come and go, Love and beauty, the colors of light, my dream. Red, gold, and green, Every day is like survival. You're my lover, not my bravo. Every day is like survival. You're my lover, not my bravo.
Oh, I'm working with a new mic system. I'm trying to find these keys. Oh, we will be soon, this.
I'm a man without conviction. I'm a man who doesn't know how to sell a contradiction. You come and go, Come a chameleon. You come and go. Love and beauty, the colors are like my dreams. Red, gold, and green. Come a chameleon. You come and go. Love and beauty, the colors are like my dreams. Red, gold, and green. Come a chameleon. You come and go. Love and beauty, the colors are like my dreams. Red, gold, and green.
Thank you, my dears. Let me bring my headphones back in.
Stunning.
Absolutely stunning.
Stunning.
Oh, she's got a whole story going on. Please hold.
I'm with you now. Let me try for you.
That was lovely.
That was really lovely.
Still getting used to the PA system that I'm working on at the moment, so I'm bear with her with that one.
That's not a problem.
I'm standing out the clap again.
So, Pip, we're going to pop you backstage and then we're going to bring you on to chat to ChrisTeen in a moment.
Okie dokies.
Evolution. So, let's talk Carmelle's creation. So, how long has she been doing the wigs, honey?
We are coming up for our year anniversary of doing the wigs. It started when we went into our first lockdown. All that time ago. It's hard to believe we've been nearly a year in and out of lockdown.
And have things changed for you in that year, in as far as like orders or frequency or anything like that? Has lots changed for you for your wigs?
Yeah. So it started off with me just doing a couple of wigs for close friends, do you want me to style you one? Okay, yeah, I'll style you one. And then it kind of turned out well, and then it got a bit of word of mouth and more word of mouth, and it just snowballed. It's like every wig I sell, if I sell a wig and they tell five people, if two or three of them five people buy another one and build in the business that way, it's started off very small.
Yes.
And now, well, it was one every few weeks. Now I'm knocking out sort of like four, five a week.
Wow.
Yeah.
And still enjoying it? Still getting the same amount of satisfaction out of it?
I am. I've taken a week off this week just to get myself a little bit of R&R, just because I have been going all the way through. So I thought I'd take a week
off.
And, Yeah, so I gave myself a little bit of a mini holiday and done something else and started making dresses, but just a little bit, make myself a frock, a new frock that I'm doing. But I thought I'd just take a little bit of a break, have some breathing space and come back to the business as of Monday.
Amazing, amazing, amazing. Well, long may it continue. We're going to pop ourselves backstage now, and Lucian's going to bring back Pippa and ChrisTeen. Or I can... Hello? Lucian! Oh, dear.
That's favoritism. Darling, we're alone at last.
Just you and me against the world, honey.
I know. How is it going, darling?
All is good, all is well. I'm extremely pleased and happy that my new palette can finally be spoken about.
The stunning new palette.
I'm gonna hold it up, babe. I'm gonna hold it up. In love with my brand new palette. I mean, just look at how beautiful she is on the inside. The oversaturation from the light doesn't show that this is a baby pink over here. You might just be able to see her. And I'm in love that finally the Show Your Pride palette is here. Woo! Yes.
And what an amazing palette it is. I absolutely adore those colours.
Oh, baby, I live for every one of them.
Yeah, it's amazing what you can do with a range of colors like that. That it's just phenomenal. Mm-hmm, there's some stunning stuff you've done.
Thank you. And that's on top of everything else I also have as well. And I'm just going to take the rein and just start gossiping about it. So I launched 1st of August 2020, and I launched with the 4 Glitterly Mineral Stardusts to compensate as a biodegradable glitter, which I have swatched some here. If I turn at the right angle, it's a bit backwards, it's a bit oversaturated. You can, yeah, so let me shake.
Yes, very shiny.
They're blinding, they're popping, babe. I'm going to use some as a highlighter today, but it can be used as a highlighter, eyeshadow, lip color, the word, you name it, you got it.
You do inspire me to cover myself in glitter.
Hello, have we met? Have we met, you and me? I live for them.
And yes, I do love a bit of glitter.
I've got them. I've got some lip products as well, which I have called Lip Sync, because she is a drag queen. So we've got the Lip Sync here, and this is one I'll be using today. It's a stunning postbox red. We're going for 80s, right? So I thought I'd whack out a red lip.
Why not?
True blood red. This is like the true, if you're looking for that, you know, proper red.
Yes.
Bam.
Yes. Because there is that problem sometimes when you're looking for a red lipstick and there's so many different shades of red, but they never come out looking red.
Precisely. And that was the feedback that I got. So when I was talking to people about what options and what are they missing in the market, they said a red that is red, not like red, not maroon red, not pale red, not sheer red. Give us a fucking red, they said. So
fantastic. Oh, well, I can't wait to see what that looks like. How exciting. I mean, one thing that I did want to kind of ask you is, when did you first get interested in makeup?
Oh, okay. So I was a little bit of a late bloomer into the makeup. I'll answer this from Neat here
first. Yeah, certainly.
So what other palettes do you have, ChrisTeen? This is the first one I have. It's the 2.0 version of this palette. We won't waste the time. I've spoken so much publicly about this. This is the newer version that is legal by trademark and copyright. The one that I used to have is no longer available, purely because of trademark and legal issues. The formula and the product was fine. However, one is the short answer to that one. This one, first of many to come. I got into Miss Pepper. Being the queen that I was, I didn't have time to sit and explore makeup. I just grabbed it, put it on, and went on stage and just thought it was all right. It just wasn't okay. Those photos need to stay in the safe, you know?
Z4s.
Mostly lockdown is when I've started to explore the theory of makeup, really.
Oh, fantastic. And how long did it take to research what kind of colours and what kind of palettes that you want to come up with?
It's hard. So I draw inspiration anyway for when I'm either launching a new collection or expanding the collection. I draw inspiration and I try to mix in there kind of bits that I want as well versus obviously what people want, because it's not just for me, it's for everybody. as well as the,
you'd have a lot of palettes if it was. I'd never run out. What's your favorite colors?
Oh, my favorite thing that I go for is a blue. I went for a passion of blues because when I started, my starting was Frozen, Let It Go. It was the first thing I ever did in drag, and I was a drag prince. So the vibe was all blues, and it's kind of stayed in my heart. But I'm having a little bit of a love affair with blue, purple, and silver as a collaboration set, as like a color story.
Fantastic. So have you got any plans to possibly come out with a fluorescent palette at some point?
Yes. So this Pride collection is supposed to evolve at some point. Not supposed to at all. It will evolve at some point. I do have ideas for a neon kind of fluorescent palette, but there's going to be others before that one comes. But it's definitely up here. It's definitely there. Oh,
I cannot wait. I cannot wait. I love my neon colours. I love your palettes because those colours are amazing. And they just go on and they're so strong. The pigment is beautiful. So you heard it here, everyone. Buy the palettes.
Listen, when I was putting the palette together, the last thing I was thinking about, well, actually the first thing, it's the last thing I wanted. I was like, I've had so many palettes where I've had to use half the pan to get some kind of colour payoff. And the first thing in my list of wants is to swipe that brush and put it on and there it is. But then also have it so that you can blend and buff it out to make something less intense with it as well, you know? And I succeeded. Here she is, the Show Your Pride palette, available at ChrisTeenCosmetics.com.
Yes, I say, artists, forget your own paint palettes. It's not acrylic, it's makeup.
Shebang.
Oh, yeah, wonderful. And,
I've got makeup as well. Most of my makeup is vegan. Every single thing that I have is cruelty-free. The glittery mineral stardusts are biodegradable. The glittery glosses that I have are also biodegradable. Everything's on the website. Every piece of information is transparent. I want complete honesty with when it comes to my products. Because I think most people can hide behind all the smokes and mirrors. I want people to know what
they're buying. The scientific words for normal things, isn't it? That I think just throws everybody. And, you know, it's nice to know what you've got going in the products that you put on your face.
Absolutely.
So fantastic.
Thank you.
I can't wait to see what else comes out of little ChrisTeen's box.
There's an extension to the Show Your Pride collection that obviously just recently relaunched, but there's already an extension coming with that very soon. In fact, I'm going to say probably within the next month, I'm expanding that collection already, the Show Your Pride collection. Yes.
Fantastic. Ooh. So you heard it here.
Which, by the way, 10% of every purchase from that Show Your Pride collection all year round will be donated back to LGBTQ plus charities across the UK. Just one of them.
And we love that. You little saint, you. We've got Lady M back. She's muted, but you're muted, darling.
Rude.
Did you hear all that? All these wonderful palettes that are coming out.
I'm chanting as we speak. I'm tapping. My little typewriter's going 10 to the dozen because we're in the 80s, obviously. Obviously, it's the typewriter.
Yeah, with the long nails so you can fit them down between the keys.
Yeah. So
that kind of thing.
No, I'm way too young. Whether the weather be fine or whether the weather be not. Whether the weather be cold or whether the weather be hot.
It's time for the weather.
We'll weather that weather, whatever the weather, whether we like it or not.
Ooh, get you.
We shall see you in a moment, Miss ChrisTeen. Pepper, when we come back from the weather, we are going to go into your solo number. So
I can't wait.
Let's go into the weather.
Perhaps Devon's having a wee-wee.
I don't know. Lucian's having a moment. Lucian! Perhaps I should help him out.
Here's the weather from Martinique Manor. Please be careful if you're out and about this week, as cold temperatures will result in icy patches developing, particularly across the lower half of the country. So please take care. Back to the studio with Lady M and Pepper.
Brains, you've got the looks, let's make lots of money. You got the brawn, I've got the brains, let's make lots of. Had enough of scheming, messing around with jerks. My car is parked outside, I'm afraid it doesn't work. I'm looking for a partner, someone who get things fixed. Ask yourself this question, do you want to be rich? I've got the brains, you've got the looks, let's make lots of money. You've got the brawn, I've got the brains, let's make lots of money. You can tell I'm educated, I studied at the Sorbonne, doctored in mathematics, I could have been a don. I can program a computer, choose the perfect time. If you've got the inclination, I've got the crime. Oh, there's a lot of opportunities. If you know when to take them, you know. There's a lot of opportunities. If there aren't, you can make them, make or break them. I've got the brains, you've got the looks. Let's make lots of money. Let's make lots of. Money. You can see I'm single-minded, I know what I could be. How'd you feel about it? Come take a walk with me. I'm looking for a partner, regardless of expense. Think about it seriously, you know it makes sense. Let's make lots of money. You've got the brawn, I've got the brains. Let's make lots of money. I've got the brains, you've got the looks. Let's make lots of money.
Well.
So, how about it?
You've got the what?
I've got the brains.
Oh, you've got no, the looks. No. No, 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 no. Brains? You? No. No. I got the brains and the look. So, Miss Pepper, that was originally covered by the, or originally produced by the Pet Shop Boys, no?
Pet Shop Boys.
Oh, yes. I'm sure they'd love to have themselves renamed into the Pepper Pet Shop Boys. So, what we're going to do is we are going to just move on. If Lucian is ready.
I'm feeling really thirsty.
Are you thirsty? I'm thirsty too.
And we are
very proud to host, as always, all the way from, well, she's technically, she's in Mexico today, isn't she? But she's heading home soon to England. But next up, we have Bella's Bar. So let's take it away with Bella's Bar. And when we come back, we're coming back to Carmelle's second song.
Hello, welcome back to Bella's Bar! Now, I know I've not uploaded for a while, but I have a really good reason. I've just got back to my Chicago apartment, so I had to do the whole traveling thing and didn't have my filming equipment. I think that's fair. But since I've got back, it is extremely cold, like -2 degrees. However, I'm not getting the snow, so it's like the kiss of death. But because I've been cold all week, I've decided today we're going to make a hot cocktail for the first time on this channel. So today, we're making a hot toddy! So, first you need to get yourself a mug. I'm using a Bellazona one, linked to where you can get your own down below. And you fill it with hot water. I recommend using a kettle. So you just got to fill it 3/4 of the way. Now's the fun part. You take your whiskey, I'm using a honey Jack Daniels because I'm that type of girl, and you do a 50ml shot. After that, now you just take a tablespoon of honey, as if I wasn't already sweet enough. Now finally, just a tablespoon of lemon juice to add a bit of zest, and give it a stir. And now we just take a sip. Fuck your lemsip, this is so much better. Now I hope that warmed your heart as much as it warmed mine, and I mean that literally. Thank you all for joining me. Please remember to subscribe as it helps grow the channel, and why would you not want to grow this fabulous channel? Have an amazing day, and I will see you all next week. Mwah!
Hello. Well, if we add Carmelle to the screen, let's have a bit of a chat. There she is. Oh, honey, and she's drinking up a storm. She's also left her. There we go. Hi.
Hiya. Oh, I've got myself a little cocktail on the go at the moment, too.
A little cocktail. Do you know why drag queens drink cocktails?
Why?
Because it makes their hands look smaller.
Exactly.
So you're going to do some more 80s for us now, and then we're going to have another little chat before ChrisTeen and Pepper have a chat. So
yeah.
I shall see you after this number. Take it away.
I think I've got the levels right this time. Well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like you, but I gotta think twice before I give my heart away. And I know all the games you play, gonna play them too. Oh, but I need some karma from that emotion. Wanna pick my heart up off the floor. Oh, when that love comes down with our devotion. But it takes a strong man, baby, but I'm showing you the door. Cause I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Baby, I know your ass asking me to say, say please, please, please don't go away, cause I'm giving you the blues. Baby, you mean every word you say, can't help but think of yesterday. I don't know who tied me down to love a boy before this river, because that ocean, before you broke my heart back on the floor. Oh baby, I'll reconsider my foolish notion, when I need someone to hold me, but I'll wait for something more. Cause I gotta have faith, I gotta have faith. Cause I gotta have faith, faith, faith. I gotta have faith, faith, faith. I gotta have faith. Gotta have faith. For this river, become that ocean, before you throw my heart back on the floor. Oh, baby, I'll reconsider my foolish notion, when I need someone to hold me, but I'll wait for something more. Cause I gotta have faith, I gotta have faith.
Let me throw my microphone back on.
Bear with.
Oh.
I am back. I have to find a way of getting this more organized next time, dear.
That's all right. Get a staff. That's what I did.
You can't pay them enough, babes.
I know. I'm keeping him locked away in a tower, apparently. So I've been told. Lucian's doing a fantastic job this evening, guys. What do you think? He's really trying his best to get everything coordinated. And we all know that Lady Martinique has high exacting standards. At least she'd like to think so. Pepper, you need to just read the private comments, Pep. She's nodding. Okay, so Carmelle, so we've chatted about you're heading for the 1 year anniversary of Carmelle's creations. Go and find them on Facebook, find them on Instagram, give them a follow. What are we looking forward to doing moving forward? I mean, what is the vision for, let's say, for your second year or for the next 6 months? Where do you want to be then?
Okay, so my usual day-to-day job is I'm a waitress.
I thought you were a pole dancer, no?
No, I just do that for tricks and a bit of
pocket money. Oh, I see.
That's only for pocket money. the last place I ended up doing a pole dance with ended up on the news. I'm a waitress or waiter by day. So I work in a steak restaurant and serve steak and chips and whatever. And this is my side hustle, which I decided to do during lockdown to create some money. Yeah. I want to take this as being my full-time job. And then working at the restaurants at the weekends, rather than working full time, rather than doing a 50-hour week at the restaurant on my feet all the time, I'd rather just work Friday and Saturday night, earn a little bit of pocket money with tips and whatnot, and do this full time during the weeks.
Amazing.
That's where the plan was when I first started, and it started taking off. And I was like, hang on, I can actually earn a bit of money and turn this into a business. Yeah. We got to probably about August, September time. I was like, hang on, I want to start taking this a bit further and making this more of a business. We made a plan that was looking at June, July is when I'm going to start making that transition from one business to the other. That's where I am. As for products, I'm trying new styles, new techniques. I've currently got one which I can show you here, which is one that I put tinsel through.
So here's one I prepared earlier.
It is a lovely tinsel rooted. Let me bring it back. Turn the camera around a little bit. She is a lovely Hollywood wave style.
Yes.
Lace front, obviously. I only work really with lace fronts. And I put all the my assistant, she may be watching downstairs. My assistant puts all the tinsel through for me.
Right.
I style them. So that's probably One of my most popular styles is the Hollywood Wave, as well as my little Marilyn ones that I do. But I'm looking to try
like
new.
Like my one.
Like your one, your Sunday wig, your church wig. This is one of the little Marilyns I've got going on.
There we go.
A playful little blonde number. Blondes have more fun. We all know that.
I have got to clean my lace front soon. Might be a job for tomorrow.
Yeah.
Right, so we're gonna pop ourselves backstage, and Pepper's gonna check in on ChrisTeen. I think.
They just love her so much.
Hello, goodbye. Ooh, that was quick.
Hello, hello.
Oh, hello again. Oh, I see there has been a progress.
Hey, gorgeous. How's she doing?
Oh, loving the eyes.
She's coming alive. I couldn't resist, Miss Pepper. I was going to, have some inspiration from Madonna in the 80s, but I just could not resist my love affair with pink, purple, and blue at the moment. So that is exactly what I used along here, these three here.
Darling, pink and blue was the 80s.
Of course it was, but I thought I'd try and mix it up and go for something different. But I've
yes, my, mine, mine's a little bit mix of blue and pink tonight. If you can see it in my toilet's hair.
Yes, babes, I love it. I love it. I love it so much. So I'm just currently putting the lashes on as well. I'm using some magnetic lashes tonight that I have from a company called Lash London. Give them a little shout out because they're fantastically fabulous. But that's all I've got to say right now.
So how are you finding the magnetic lashes? Because I've heard that some people like them, some people don't like them. And, what's ChrisTeen's?
ChrisTeen, it has the seal of approval from ChrisTeen. It really does. And I'm not all fingers and thumbs. I can be quite delicate and precise with, thank you, Anita. Thank you, Neats. My mistake, Neats. Thank you, Neats, so much, honey. I love them. I cannot fault them. If you can get your hands on a set of magnetic lashes, do. That's what I say. They're so approved by me. You can see them go in a second.
Be so much easier to take off.
Oh my God. Ooh, babes, I'm not even complete yet, babes. But thanks.
You're going to slay them.
So convenient. And none of this waiting around for lash glue to dry. There's magnetic eyeliner. Shove it on. I mean, this is not my product, but you shove it on, you get it on, and you put this on. If you can get some, because they are thebomb.com.
Perhaps that's something you could have a little conversation with the company that makes them to produce a range of eyeliners in different colours that are magnetic.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, that's definitely something for me to look into.
See, businesswomen, always thinking.
The neats love magnetics as well, babe. There's no faffing around.
Yeah.
Get it on. What else have I got, Chuck? Gossip about for you. I've got some liquid lipsticks as well that I sell. These are lightly scented, again very pigmented. I'll just put on this purple here that's called Stunning. She is everything. I didn't get enough on there, my bad. Look at her.
Well, that's definitely purple.
I've not got it even across. That's embarrassing. There we go.
Now, I thought you were going for the I've just been eating a blackcurrant ice pole look.
I have been just eating a blackcurrant ice pole look. What do you mean? That is not even a cross. I've got a bit of a drip here. Where there we go.
Oh, that's amazing.
And that as well. And TB told, you don't need no makeup remover to take these off. Like, these have a longer. I recorded a video when I launched these and I put it out somewhere, I can't remember where right now. And I was drinking a drink. I let it set, let it dry. And I was drinking for 15 minutes. I held up my phone on a timer and it didn't come off. And it was sip after sip. I drank so much water, babe. I was bloated, I was heavy, but it was worth it because it proved the point. These last, these are so
fantastic.
Lasting.
Yes, there's nothing worse, putting a lipstick on, and as soon as you've got it on, it started coming off, and then you're just left with that horrible outline, and then it really disappeared in the middle.
Absolutely, absolutely. And they are as is, you know, like what you get it, you get it. I'm thinking about doing some kits in the future. But not anytime soon. It's not my thing. But they all last. And at the moment, there's the pink that's called Approve. You've got Stunning, that's the purple. You've got Tease, which is this kind of rich ocean teal blue. And then we've got Miss Deviation, which is the postbox red. This is everything. People have purchased this when they said it's their go-to red. So I'm really happy for that.
Fab. Wonderful. So pleased to hear that it's just you're getting so many people kind of contacting you going, we've heard how wonderful your makeup products are, and they come and watch you, and
I love how
it's fantastic.
Thank you, Pepper. I appreciate you saying that. I'm loving how things are progressing, not just as the cosmetics, but also as a drag artist as well. How I'm pushing myself forward, and I'm creating videos every week for you guys, and I'm pushing myself into doing that.
I love them.
Yes, so thank you again for having me. Just to quickly answer Neats here, plenty.
Yes, sir.
Plenty is the answer.
Yes, it's money. It's money. Answer it.
Again, I have invested again. It's my second investment into palettes because of the first mess up that I ended up facing. So there's plenty of these palettes. So please get purchasing. I'd appreciate it. And I think there's a little bit of a distrust when it comes to cosmetics, with especially new stuff. You know, people are familiar with what they know. People are comfortable in their brands. But trust when I say it's me, it's real. It's not someone hiding behind some big marketing campaign trying to take someone's dollar. This is a person. This is a small business. This is a drag business. Support it and love it.
Exactly. And when you know it's a good product, people are going to keep coming back.
And they do. I've got so many great customers, and I love them all. Just you all need to hear about it and do it.
Wonderful. I keep wondering about my shoulder pads. I think there's something happening with them tonight. It's kind of every time I go off, and kind of they either move or they get bigger. I just don't know what's happening with it at the moment.
Shoulder pads need to make a comeback. Okay, Neats, I'll speak to you soon about it, gorgeous. I'm open. I love a shoulder pad. Shoulder pads need to come back. They need to make a comeback.
Definitely. But it's making me very hot.
Oh, yeah. That's because you are extremely hot, babe, and you know you are.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's the heat in the room that does it. Oh, wonderful. I'm just going to quickly check on our timeline and see how everything's going. Oh, we're still fantastic. We've still got plenty of time. So wonderful. So you've done your eyes, and you're going to finish with your lips.
Yes, so I'm going to take this off. This was just to show you how it is, and it's already dry.
Oh, exactly. And the good thing is the fact that you can take that off and then put a completely different colour on, because I know damn well I end up with purple face, red face, once I've taken it off. So I always look like I've been, I don't know, rubbing my face with a dish brush.
Absolutely. The common mistake is that you don't use a new part of the wipe. They use the same wipe twice, and it kind of smudges it. Yeah, but I was considering, like, these are technically a lip stain, but I've called them a lip stay because they stay on your lips. They don't stain your lips. I mean, already there's just a little bit of irritation rub. That's all it is. But if I leave this off, you'll see the irritation go down, and there's no purple.
Yeah.
Around, and it's already dried, and it's good to go. You don't need no special remover. You don't need no second product. Buy it as it is.
Fantastic. That's what we love, is we love makeup that anyone can put on. It looks phenomenal. And when it comes to taking it off, it's off.
It's off.
No fuss, no bother. You know, 17 different products, forget it.
Indeed.
Water, flannel, done.
And most, I researched into this, most palettes have a problem when going vegan and cruelty-free about the red and sometimes the pinks. because the product that is vegan within Red, the colorant that makes it cruelty free, is called Red 21. And Red 21 can sometimes stain the skin because of how intense it is, because of the dyes that have been used in it and the chemical part. However, Red 21, yes, but it doesn't stain. There's no stainage. So Mr. James Giles had huge backlash with his palette when he collaborated with Morphe because of the staining that people had for days. Days.
Yes, yes. Nobody likes staining for days.
No. The only thing I like to remember for days is the fella. And that's only if I don't get too drunk with him, you know, like if I can remember his name. That's the only thing I want to remember.
Oh, exactly, exactly. Well, we're soon to be coming up on Lady M's song for tonight.
Ooh, Miss Lady M come and perform.
Mm-mm-mm. Oh, yes, she is. So I think I can hear her down the other end of the hall. So we'll let you go back, continue on, and we'll see you in a little while.
Thank you, babe. See you soon.
See you soon. Lady M.
My giddy giddy gosh. How the Aya, this is a fan. I am extremely hot and extremely sweaty. I made the rookie mistake of not filming this when the face was fresh, probably about, I don't know, a fair few hours ago. I don't know if this is an accurate, lovely representation of how it was hours ago. Anyway, let me talk through what we've got. I'm using the Show Your Pride palette, in fact. I'm using the blues. I'm using the two blues here and the black. And then, I'm using the Glittery Mineral Stardust in shade Performance. Oh my God, I am absolutely exhausted. To help pop and highlight the inner corners and stuff. And then for the lips, I used three pencils and, where's my gloss? Three pencils and the Glittery Gloss, which is biodegradable, FYI handy. I decided today to do some buff, bitch. Let's put this on because I'm still hot. I decided today to do some boss bitches who I think are bosses according to oneself. So I've done Britney Spears and Madonna. So just enjoy the freaking show because I'm hot and I need to go soak in like the freezer or something. So, ciao for now! People in the crowd, grab a partner, take it down. It's me against the music. It's just me and me. Yeah, come on.
Yeah. over here, I got something to show ya. Sexy lady, I'd rather see you bare your soul. If you think you're so hot, better show me what you got. All my people in the crowd, let me see you dance. Come on, Britney, lose control. Watch you take it down.
Wasn't that good? Oh. What was her name again? It's something Spears. I didn't quite get her first name. Doesn't Britney mention her own name?
Britney, bitch.
Yes. Hashtag free Britney.
That's what she said. Hashtag free Britney. Absolutely. Have you watched that documentary?
No.
There's a free Britney documentary on Netflix at the moment. Go and watch it. Homework.
I certainly will do. I think I'm being overrun with my shoulder pads, but never mind.
Yes, I want to talk about that because, you know, mine have been quite stately this evening, but all of a sudden my bosoms have gone to about 16 sizes larger because of my subtle shoulder pads. But yours have made you into a football player. You're turning into a quarterback.
You know what it is?
What?
You remember when we were doing Martinique Air?
Yes.
And that bloody inflatable vest.
Oh.
These jackets, these shoulder pads, were made by the same company.
I see. So you're overloaded with your floaters?
Yes. But at least if I fall into water, I know I'll survive.
Really? It's a lovely little segue, that.
Oh, yes, it is. Now that I've managed to find you.
Yes, dear.
You're going to be singing your song next, aren't you, dear?
I am. So, I shall see you afterwards.
Don't be long, darling.
Okay, darling. Bye.
Not soon.
There we go. Here's a little song I thought would be quite appropriate for this evening, seeing as we're back in the 80s. At first I was afraid, I was petrified, kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong, and I grew strong, and I learned how to get along. And so you're back from outer space. I just walked in to find you here with that sad look upon your face. I should have changed that stupid lock. I should have made you leave your key. If I'd have known for just 1 second, you'd be back to follow me. Go on now, go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now, 'cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to hurt me with goodbyes? Did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh no, not I. I will survive. For as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my life to live, and I've got all my love to give. I'll survive. I will survive. Hey, hey. It took all the strength I had not to fall apart, just trying hard to mend the pieces of my broken heart. And I spent oh so many nights just feeling sorry for myself. I used to cry, but now I hold my head up high, and you'll see me, somebody new. I'm not the chained up little person still in love with you. And so you felt like dropping in and just expect me to be free. Well, now I'm saving all my loving for someone who's loving me. Go on now, go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now. Cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to work me with goodbyes? Did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh no, not I. I will survive. Oh, as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my life to live, and I've got all my love to give. I will survive. I will survive. Oh. Go on now, go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now, cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to hurt me with goodbyes? Did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh no, not I. I will survive. For as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my life to live, and I've got all my love to give, and I'll survive. I will survive. I will survive. Yay! Miss Bill has come to sing along as well. Miss Bill has come to sing. So that was I Will Survive. Little apt at the moment for things going on, things happening, things moving, things changing. And we have got lots on the cards, lots changing, lots happening here at Martinique Manor and beyond. Thanks, Jane. Thanks, Howard. Hello, Miss Bella. Where's my darling partner in crime? There she is. Hello, trouble. Oh, hello, microphone. There we go.
Oh.
Go on now, go. No? Oh.
I think I've popped.
I think you've sprung a leak, dear. Have you sprung a leak?
Either that or I've developed a hunchback.
Oh. Or, you know, an asymmetric look was very big in the 80s.
It's asymmetrics.
Asymmetrics are very, very big in the 80s. Another thing that was big in the 80s was taking tea and having tea. And I know a lady who is very, very good at taking tea and testing out a soggy biscuit.
Yes.
So without further ado, I think we need to ask Lucian to pop up Miss Marble's soggy biscuits.
Today we will be looking at one of Britain's best love biscuits, the Bourbon Cream. Invented in 1863 by Colonel Bourbon Cream, the Bourbon Cream was made from the finest cocoa grown in the country. In fact, it was the exact same cocoa as that grown in the Champagne region of France. It has a exotic and nubile cocoa cream layer, lovingly caressed between two slim yet athletic ebony bodies. Initially, you are hit with the aromas of chocolate, wild safaris, and sweaty, semi-naked warriors as they dance around a fire. Its texture is firm, wild, and abandoned, like a lion hunting a mate. On to the dunk test. 1, 2, 3. As you can see, the biscuit has indeed remained intact. Even the power of the tea is unable to break down the walls that protect the cocoa goddess inside. However, the dunked section has sucked the moisture, and one would assume it would leave a satisfying chocolatey feel in the mouth. It's for this reason that the Bourbon cream gets a soggy biscuit rating of 7. Join us next week as we search for Britain's best soggy biscuit. I think she was slightly aroused by that.
I want to know about something to do with the cocoa goddess inside, or whatever the two chocolate. I mean,
deal with this.
Where does she get her information from?
I don't know. Honestly, she goes off on these trips elsewhere and comes back and is like, I've seen tomato and all that kind of thing. And we're all like, yeah, whatever. Because everywhere you go, there's a murder. And you always solve it.
Right.
So perhaps it's something she picked up while she was away.
Like the clap, yeah.
Yes, possibly. I've heard syphilis ruins your brain.
Oh, I wouldn't know, dear. So whilst I was singing, I realised I have no water in this room with me or any beverage of any sort. And I was... I had a frog in my throat, and I'm thinking, how on earth do I finish this song? Because my eyes started tearing up as well. So it was a little bit of a mission, actually. So, Pepper, we are more than halfway through the show. We are much more than halfway through the show. We've got 20 minutes left. We have yet to have Carmel's final number. We're going to have a bit of a chat with Carmel, and we're going to have ChrisTeen's reveal, her grand reveal, darling. So all of that coming up really, really soon. I think without further ado, I shall pop you backstage, Pepper, if we can, Lucian. He's so efficient. And we shall bring back Carmelle, darling, to join me. There she is. Volume, darling, volume. Pop your mic back on.
Hello.
There she is.
Hey.
Hi. Hello. Is this thing on? What are you wearing? So tell us, the hair that you are sporting this evening,
yeah,
is that a new Carmelle's Creations design?
This is one of the ones that I've had for a while that I like. It's my go-to wig when I've got a couple that I've styled. You've seen a couple of the ones I've made.
Yes.
This one you haven't seen before.
I haven't.
This one I made about four years ago. It was an old faithful one that I bring out for when I do like the odd gig here and there. It kind of goes with the 80s look. It's like frizzy and big and
yeah. But it's a Carmelle creation. It is one of yours.
It's one that I made myself. Yep.
Amazing.
Two wigs, one stacks on top of the other. And,
yes.
Yeah. A little bit of a playful one. So I'm not a big fan of making ponytail wigs. I will say that now. I'm not a big fan of making them, only because there's I don't know.
Are they more tricky to make? Tricky to...
I prefer the tees and the big statement drag hair. This seems, for me, this feels a little bit pedestrian, but I know some people don't have like the big drag hair, sort of like the Vegas style. I like making the big Vegas style wigs, but yes, then also, I will still make these ones if people ask me.
Amazing. Stunning. Well, Carmelle, we are going to give you the full screen, Lucian, if you don't mind, and we're going to hear your final number.
Let me take this out, only because there we go. That's a bit better. I'm going to do a little bit of divine for you this evening, my dears. And also, being 80, we're going to go for a little bit of this. There we go.
No. And a black man will look me in the eye. Turn around. Take one final look at what you let me hide. Then walk away from the great love you had never known. Yes, walk away. You're telling me that you can make it on your own by yourself. All alone without my help, listen, you just made a big mistake. You think you're a man, but you're only a boy. You think you're a man, you are only a toy. You think you're a man, but you jump to the sea. You were bad enough to satisfy me. Take a look around and tell me what you find. Yes, shop the ball. Take a giant step for you and all mankind. Then don't come back. I always give you so much more than you deserve. No, don't come back. Cause no one makes up for me. You've got now to walk away. Pop the lens, I'm gonna say. Lindsay, you just made a big mistake. You think you're a man, but you're only a boy. You think you're a man, you are only a toy. You think you're a man, but you just couldn't see. You were man enough to satisfy me.
Throw my headphone back in just so I can hear Lady Martinique.
There she is, ladies and gents. Miss Carmelle Toe. Give it up for Miss Carmelle Toe. What comments do we have for her, Lucian?
2 seconds. Let me just connect that
while she's adding herself back in.
I'll have to invest in some wireless headphones, I think so.
That's all right. I think we all have the similar problems at the moment, don't we?
A little bit of neon for you, dear.
So we were talking about the Diva Rules earlier when we were doing our makeup, weren't we? And you said you've actually had a copy signed by Michelle Visage herself.
Yes, I do. I went to the live reading book. She done sort of like a Q&A session when she released the book.
Right. And it was
hosted by Meth, I think the drag queen called Meth from East London.
Okay.
Yeah, and she was talking about the book. We asked her some questions. And then afterwards, she done the signing, had a little bit of a chit-chat, and she signed my book for me, to Carmelle Toe. And weirdly enough, she did say to me that Carmelle was the name that she used when she first started doing the Vogue Balls back in sort of like the sort of 80s.
Amazing. Amazing, yeah. Amazing, amazing. Really, really lovely. Really, really lovely. I'm not sure whose clicking sounds those are. They might be me.
Might be my earrings because they are very... turn me like that. I've got a lovely set of new earrings, which I will, speaking of businesses, I will promote who they are from. These are from Mark Bowen Staged Jewels.
Amazing.
I think you're friends with them as well.
Yes, I am.
Yes.
He's just recently had a bereavement. So that's interesting.
Yeah, I know, sadly. He done an auction, even though what's been going on recently, he done an auction last week. And I picked up these in the auction last week. They're very statement.
Get you, Miss Thrifty, and find it. Find it, honey. Grab it quickly before it goes.
Yeah, I might attach my Bluetooth to it just so I can look fabulous while I'm on the treadmill.
So we're going to bring we're going to bring Pepper Spray back to do her final reveal and interview with ChrisTeen before we shut down the show for the evening. So thank you, Carmelle. Hang around. We are going to do a little goodbye in a moment. But before that, let's bring back Pepper Spray.
Drum roll. Lights. Camera, action. It's now time for the reveal. Ladies, gentlemen, and everyone in between, please put your hands together for the one and only fabulously stunning Miss ChrisTeen. ChrisTeen, come on, darling. Don't be shy.
Hello.
Hi, yay.
Just wearing something a little bit more casual today, just something a little bit more pedestrian.
I thought we've not been gone that long. Your hair couldn't have grown that quickly.
I'll tell you what, babe, it's taken a lifetime to grow. Did you see that I haven't covered my hair up now? Finally.
Hair problems. Oh, wonderful. That Thank is just you. So 80s.
Mm-hmm. Look at this lipstick. Look at this color. Isn't she stunning? Mm. I love this red.
She's going to be needing some private mirror time afterwards.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Jessie, babes. Thank you, honey. I appreciate you saying that. Yes. And I've laid the Glittery Mineral Stardust in the colour performance, which is the silver. You have to build her as a highlighter only because when you put her on, it's like, bam, here's the pigment. Like, it's full pigment. So you need to go little and often to get the desired result. But she's not a buildable product. She is bam.
Yes. Yeah, so there's nothing worse than putting shining highlighter on and having it look like you've just been 7 hours in a sweat lodge and you're not glowing anymore, dear.
Exactly. Thank you for having me, Miss Pep. I've so thoroughly enjoyed myself.
It's been wonderful to have you.
I love putting that video together. Did you see the video?
I always get a sneaky peek of them.
Oh, I love that. Maybe Martinique didn't see it before then because she said absolutely nothing about it when she came back.
Well, we're trying a new format tonight, so it's kind of we're kind of looking between lots of different screens at the moment.
Yes, of course. I thought with Lucian being here to assist, she might have a bit more time to engage, but apparently not.
Oh, no, she'll be here any second because it's almost the time for the end of the show.
It's almost time. Do you know what? I'll drop into her DMs and I hope I get a reply from her this time. I hope we need to book in a catch up. It's been too long since I've heard a reply.
I'll tell you something, I cannot wait for the day when I can go out and I can have a drink and I can talk to my friends and we've all become indoor drinkers, haven't we?
Oh honey, I was a drinker before lockdown, but I was always able to reply to someone's message no matter how drunk I was.
Oh, she heard you.
Oh, I'm glad.
She's mute.
Unmute, my lovely.
I was checking on my assistant, not my concubine, my assistant.
Concubine.
Well, you know, behind closed doors, darling. No. None of that. We were busy sorting out format tonight. It has been a learning curve, a steep learning curve for all of us. But Lucian has done a fantastic job. Drop him a message if you want to. Our new backstage boy. Oh, control. Our control tower bitch. He will be running the show, and I'm sure once he knows the ropes properly, he's going to be cracking whips at us, which, you know.
Ooh, I yes. cannot wait. It's been a long time since I've been cracked to whip on, babe. I am more than willing.
Oh, I wonder what Carmelle feels about whips. Carmelle, you'd care to comment? Oh, no, she's also on mute.
Stunned.
Someone keeps muting me. I don't know who doesn't like my voice. I love a good whipping, darling. Whipped cream is my favourite.
Whipped cream.
Stones may break my bones, but whips and chains excite me.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
My safe word is Shaka Khan.
Shaka Khan.
If you can get your safe word out in time, it's Shaka Khan. Ladies, big business, as we all know, starts with small business, and all four of us are experienced in starting some format of little sideline business at home. It was a hope, it was a dream, it was a wish. And with that hope, dream, and wish, we built on that. We're building our audiences. We are collaborating with each other, working together. But we all know the benefit of a good, old, solid, creative idea that's bringing us to where we are. And you know what? All four of us can say that we really and truly love what we are doing. Yeah. I didn't actually show anything, did I?
No.
I've got a gorgeous purple and gold one this evening. That's the first one. And the other one I brought out because I thought, you know, it's similar in tone. This is one that I actually made for Carmelle to show her. It's the gunmetal gray and black. Wow. Yeah. And they're very full, as Carmelle will tell you, and Pepper. They're very full boas. They are scrunched boas. I'm not gonna make a big deal out of them. They are scrunched, which means there's a length of fabric and they're gathered along the fabric, but they are magnetically linked. And so if you keep them as a circle, you won't ever have to worry about anything else other than just fluffing her up once in a while. We all love a good fluff, don't we?
Exactly.
Yes, I do.
And they
I
also do, help with proportions as well, because
they like, do.
It brings your body into proportion, because I have a big waist, so yes. I need to make the shoulders bigger to make it look like my waist is smaller. So for drag queens who have issues with proportionizing, that's a good
one. One of my drag daughters the other night wore hers on another show, and she actually sent me a message afterwards saying, you know, I hate my arms naturally. She is a female drag daughter. You all know her as Thoroughly Modern Marilyn. And she said, I really don't like the top of my arms. They don't feel natural for me. So she's like, I wear mine and it actually hides the bits that I don't like. Yeah. And I feel gorgeous in this organza boa. So anybody wanting boas? Yes, it's like a little marshmallow or a cloud. Anybody wanting a boa, get hold of us at House of Martinique, and we can do bespoke boas just for you of Miss Carmelle Toe. Anybody wanting makeup, there's nowhere else to go now, girls. To Christine.
This is the only place to get makeup.
Makeup is fab.
Between all of us, we just need someone to sell talent, and then we could actually package a whole drag queen in one go.
Literally.
We just need nails as well.
absolutely. Right, so thank you ladies, all of you, for joining us here this evening. Thank you one and all.
Thank you for having me as usual.
We've got comments from all over the world. Janice is of course joining us from Durban in South Africa. I've known Janice for longer than I care to remember. I've probably known Janice for about 20 years. I've known Janice at least. So thank you. Everybody else, please take care of yourselves. We would love to see you all soon. Send us a message. Go ahead and follow all my sisters here and see what they can do for you. Everybody here is happy to help with advice. Sorry?
So catch us all up on YouTube as well.
Catch us all up on YouTube.
Go on there.
Carmelle, are you on YouTube yet?
I do have an account, but I haven't used it in ages, so I need to get that up and running.
Okay. Miss ChrisTeen, you've got a YouTube, yes? You do?
I do. It's ChrisTeen the Drag Queen. However, what I post there are mostly just what I put on the Instagram and the old Facebook. Yeah. They're all kind of linked. I've not got specific content for YouTube. That's something for the future.
Amazing. Thank you, ladies. We shall look forward to seeing you all soon. So from us here, thank you to Lucian for working our control room. Let's do a naughty thing and just bring him on. Oh, there he is. Lucian, wave at everyone. With his Christmas tree in the background, let's shame his mother. We love you, Neets.
Hi.
Oh, Neets is going to kill me.
Oh dear.
Christmas is here again. So thank you, ladies. Thank you, Lucian. And we shall look forward to seeing you all again next week for Live Lounge at Martinique Manor. Yeah. Bye.
See you.